Hey guys, it's me, Little Mimi. This past weekend, I went to a-kon 29. I've been going to this con specifically since I was 13, so about 6 years now. I had a great time, as always, cosplaying and just being around people who like anime as much as I do. Joann came along also, and it was his first con, and he absolutely loved it. In this video, though, I'll be showing you how I made my Tiana work cosplay. To see more of my cosplays, follow my cosplay Instagram. It will be right here for you to follow. But for now, let's get into how I made this. So I get all of my fabric from Joann's fabric store. This is a white cotton fabric that I'm going to be using for my apron. Always buy extra though, in case you mess up. I bought a yard and a half for this. So to begin, I'm seeing how wide and long I want the apron to be for me. This will be different for you depending on your preference on how you want the apron to be. Also, it will be different because you may be taller or shorter than me. Now her apron is in like a pentagon-like shape, so I find the middle and connect the two sides, making sure that they are as even as possible. And again, it should look like a pentagon, but just upside down. Then I like to pin my fabric before I cut it, just in case it moves, so everything is just straight when I go to sew it later. So yeah, I just pin it and then I just cut it out. Next, I start working on her pocket. She has one on her right-hand side. I just sketch out a U-like shape and connect it at the top, and also make sure it's big enough for my notepad that she uses to take orders fits. And then again, I pin it and I cut it out, and again, it goes on the right-hand side. Now moving on to how I made the straps. They are 90 centimeters long and 3 inches wide. This is layered fabric, so in total for the strap pieces, there should be 4. So now since we have all the pieces for the apron cut out, we are about to sew them together. You should have 2 strips, a pocket, and the main part of the apron. Again, these are all double layered and are folded over fabric. So for each item that I just listed, there should be 2 pieces of fabric. So in total, there should be 8 pieces of fabric. Before sewing, I recommend ironing the fabric before just to get all the wrinkles out. So I found out that the apron was actually too long for me and also the dress. It's supposed to stop almost at the end of the dress, but not past the dress like it's doing here. So all I just do is trim off a few inches. So I do suggest that before you do any final sewing that you check to your proportions that that everything is correct, because once everything's sewn, it's going to be really hard to go backwards. So this part gets really confusing. It may just be better for you to watch what I'm doing, but you're going to take your strips and go into sew on one side of them. They should now open up like a book, and you should still have 2 pieces. Then you are going to join those 2 pieces in the middle and sew one side, making sure that they are aligned and that they now make one long strip. Now you're going to fold over the side and to pin it down, and you are going to sew the non-sewed side and leaving an opening at the end so you can flip it out. So this part can be pretty hard if you do not have a long ruler or a broomstick. To flip this out, you're going to pull it through and just keep pushing till it is flipped out on the outside. And once you're done, you're going to pull it off and you should have one long strip. Now I'm going to pin the strip to the apron and sew it together. I am making sure that the strip is even and directly in the middle of the main part of the apron. So when sewn, the strips on the side are the same lengths, so it just looks a lot neater and clean. So also when I go to sew the tie at the back, it just sits nicely and even. So moving on to the dress part, I got this yellow dress off Amazon for cheap. The link for it will be in the description below for you. Basically, all you need for the dress is a darker shade of yellow cotton fabric and matching thread to match. Her dress is a V-cut dress with a white undershirt. For the V-cut, all you need to do is find the middle of the dress and cut out the V-shape. Make sure you only cut out the V-neck to the front of the dress and don't cut any part of the back of the dress. Next, I go on to make the collar for the dress. I don't know how to make one, so I was trying all these weird shapes and stuff till I finally came up with this shape. I sewed the inside of it, and then I flipped it out, and then I sewed all around the outside of it so it would lay flat. So next, I'm just connecting the collar pieces to the dress. All I did was just simply pin it and sew them together. So next I went on to the white part of the V-neck. You could just wear a white cami underneath for this part, but I chose to make it a part of the cosplay permanently. All I did was just sew two triangles together, leaving the bottom part open so I could flip it out. Then I just sewed that opening closed from the outside, and I just sewed that part to the V-neck part of the dress. And lastly, for the pocket, all you need to do is pin it to the apron and sew it as close to the edge as possible, and of course leaving the top open so it is a pocket. And that is how I made my Tiana cosplay. If you enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up letting me know. And also tell me in the comments if you like these types of videos. I am getting back into cosplay, and I wouldn't mind just filming my process for you guys. So that is all for me today. Bye. Trials and tribulations, I've had my share. There ain't nothing gonna stop.